Hey everyone, Kevin Blanco here, Senior Developer Relations Advocate at Appsmith, and your trusty guide to unlocking the potential of internal enterprise apps. Today, I'm extremely excited to show you how easily migrate data from spreadsheets to a PostgreSQL database using Appsmith completely for free. Appsmith is the no-code and low-code fully open-source platform that is revolutionizing how businesses build internal tools, reducing slow, expensive development cycles, eliminating tedious steps, and enabling rapid iteration with less room for error. And it's a perfect platform to create a migration tool thanks to its native integration with more than 30 data sources. On average, customers reduce migration time by 62% and save 4 developer days per migration using Appsmith. So today's topics are, first of all, connecting your databases and data sources like spreadsheets so you can easily bring your existing data. Then we will customize the migration logic so you can transform it on the fly. And last but not least, we will output the data to the desired destination so you can accelerate migrations and reduce time from days to hours. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, let's start with the first step. Let's bring the data sources into our application. Here we have an empty Appsmith application, and we're going to connect, first of all, Google Sheets to bring a spreadsheet where I have the content, and then the Postgres database. That's going to be the destination of the data. So in order to do that, we have to go to the data section here in Appsmith and bring our own data. So like I said, the first one is going to be Google Sheets. So let's select Google Sheets. And here we need to put a name. I'm going to call it events source. And the reason why I'm calling it events is because we are going to be migrating data about an online event conference from this spreadsheet into a Postgres database. Now, this is a very normal use case, for example, in agencies and companies where marketing team is creating the content in spreadsheets, but you need to migrate that data into a actual database in the application. Now we need to tell Appsmith if we want to give it permission to all of the sheets in the Google Drive or just specific sheets. Right now I'm just going to say one, and I'm going to select which one is going to be. It's going to take us to the Google authentication in order to authenticate with Google Drive. And now it's going to show us all of the Google Sheets that I have in my account. As you can see here, I have the event spreadsheet. That's the one I need. And that's it. Appsmith has brought the Google Sheet into Appsmith, and now we can see all the data. Now it's important to notice that this data is actually plugged in into the Google Sheet. If you make updates to the Google Sheet, it will be reflected on Appsmith. And also if you make changes to this data source, you will be able to see them on the actual sheet. And as you can see, we have the title, description, category, a speaker, topic, etc. about these events. Now, in a more real life scenario, you might have different tables in your data source. For example, you might have the speakers table, you might have the locations table, the rooms. But for this specific demo, we're just gonna bring data from one Google Sheet into one table in Postgres. But the concept will be pretty much the same. Now let's bring the second data source, which is the Postgres database. That's gonna be our events destination. So that's the name we're gonna put, events destination. And now let's enter the credentials. Here I have this Postgres database that I have running on Neon. The name is going to be migration. The username is Kevin, and my password, I'm not going to say it, so you cannot steal it. All of the password fields in Appsmith, they are encrypted, and they cannot never be retrieved back once you save. So let's test the configuration, and as you can see, the connection is success. And let's save the information. So there you go. Now we have the two data sources we need, the source and the actual destination. Let's do something on the editor so we prepare for the second step on this demo. Let's actually see the data from those specific tables. So I'm going to bring a table widget into the canvas, and I'm going to put a text field here, a text widget, to say that this is going to be our source. Source data. And let's connect the data from the event source, the event Google Sheet source. Now let's select the events spreadsheet. And what sheet we want to bring? We're going to bring the Tech Conference Events 2024, the table header index, that's fine. And then what's going to be for the searchable column, which is going to be the title. So that's it. Here we will be able to sneak peek the data that we got from the spreadsheet. Then we're going to move into the production database. Now, I don't want this to be any editable table, so I'm going to toggle that off because only I want to see data. I don't want to edit the data on this table, at least for the sake of this demo. Now, let's do the same, but with the destination. Let's put it here. The title is going to be destination. And let's bring another table widget. Let's put the table widget in here down below. Let's make it a bit small so you can see the two tables. And this one is going to be plugged in into the events destination Postgres database, public event tables. Again, title is going to be for the searchable column. And there you go. Now we will be able to see that on the Postgres database, we just have one event, and that's fine. And we can see all of the events on the Google Sheet. Right now, we have five pages. Each page has like five. So we have around 20 events on the Google Sheets, and we only have one here on the production database. So now we are prepared to jump to the second one, which is going to be actually coding JavaScript code to migrate data from one place to the other one. All right, let's go to the second step. Now that we have both data sources connected and we can see the data on the actual UI, we can start writing our queries in JavaScript code. Now, the first thing we want to do is actually create the insert query to the Postgres database. That's very simple to do. And actually, Appsmith already creates queries for us when we create a new data source. As you can see, we created the Postgres data source and the Google Sheet data source. And for each of those, Appsmith created the insert, select, total records, and update, as well for the Google Sheet. You can find insert, total, and update. So that way we have a baseline for the crude standard queries. Let's edit the insert public event. And actually, I'm just going to call it insert event for simplicity. And as you can see, this query right here is actually using the data from the table. But in this case, we're not going to be inserting data from the actual table into the query. We're going to be doing it via JavaScript. And we're going to be passing dynamic parameters to it. So that's why we have to use the this, that params property in order to pass parameters from another source. In this case, it's going to be the JavaScript file. So the way we do this is super simple. All we have to do is create the insert query. In this case, I'm passing the title, description, the topic, etc. And the values are going to come, like I said, from the this, that, params object. For example, this, that, params, that, title, this, that, params, that, category, this, that, params, daytime, and so on and so forth. Lastly, we want to use prepared statements, so that way the query functions as we expect. So that means that now if we go to JavaScript, we create a new object, we will be able to call insert underscore event and actually pass data into it and create a new event in our database. So let's actually do that. Let's create a new JavaScript object and we're going to call it migration. And here Appsmith normally creates a structure that we can use as a sample. We can have parameters, we can have properties, we can have asynchronous function and standard synchronous function. I'm going to use the actual asynchronous function. So I'm going to delete all of this structure and I'm going to call it migrate data. And this one doesn't really need any parameters, so we're going to leave it like this. And in theory, here we can basically write our code, call our function and pass parameters. Also, if you want, you can actually use Appsmith AI here to create the new query structure in case you're not, you know, you're wondering how that works. So what we have to do is type backslash Appsmith AI and then the prompt will be shown. So I'm going to say I need to run the insert event that run passing test values. So right now we're going to call insert event passing test values, and then what we're going to do is just change the values from the data from the Google Sheet. So let's see if Appsmith AI actually make a structure that works for us. If not, I have a structure here so I can show you. But at the end, all we have to do is call insert event.run and pass the parameters that we created on the actual query. So as you can see here, it is. We have the parameters, and then we have the await insert event.run params. And since this is a synchronous function, that's why we have to use await. So let's give it a shot. Let's see if it actually works. I'm just going to click run the migrate data function and see if that actually works. Probably we're not going to see any type of response because we didn't have any return statement, but also we don't have errors or logs. So in theory, if we go back to our widgets and we refresh our page, we should see a new event created on the destination database. And there it is, actually. As you can see, test conference, test description, tech, that's the actual structure that we pass from our JavaScript object. So there you go. It looks like all we have to do is just call insert that event, that run, pass the parameters that we need, and now we're ready to start passing dynamic data from the Google Sheet into the database. So I have the code here ready, so let's take a look at it. So that way we can go over it. It's pretty much the same structure, but all we have to do is call the, there you go. Let me see here. There you go. So let's see what we're doing here. The first thing is we are wrapping the map event of all of the data from the Google Sheet into a variable. Then we will use a try catch statement to actually try to migrate all of the data from the Google Sheet into the database using the same structure which you saw, which is insert event.run. So what I'm doing is creating a const called migrate all events, and I'm calling total record tech conference events 2024. That's the name of the query that gets the data from the Google Sheet. That's the same query that actually fits the table that we have in the UI. As you can see, here it is, total record tech. So that's, long story short, it gets all the data from the Google Sheet. Then we're gonna access the data property. This actually has the data of all of the information on the sheet. And then we're gonna do a map function. So the map function is going to go through all of the different events on this data object. And then it's going to map each event into this event property. So that means that what we're gonna do is for each event in the Google Sheet, we want to execute the insert event query to the Postgres database to insert a new event. And that's it. All we have to do is the same structure we noticed right before, but instead of passing a hard-coded value, we're just gonna pass the actual event information. Remember, the event property here is basically the event on the map iteration function. And that's it. So now all we have to do is, like I said, use the try catch statement here to basically call a promise to migrate all the events. And then whenever that's done, we're going to show an alert saying that the events migrated successfully, and then basically run select public events that run. Why is this? Because we want to pull the data once again at the end from the Postgres database, so we can actually see all the data on the table widget reflected after the migration. And then we can return the results. So that should be it. Let's take a look at it and see if we can run it. Now, we're not gonna run it directly here. We're actually going to bind this to a button widget. So all we have to do is go here, find our button. Let's put our button here and let's call it start migration. What's gonna happen here is on the click event, we actually want to call the JavaScript function, migration, migrate data, and that's it. Let's give it a shot, let's deploy. And let's click start migration. And there you go, we have the toast or the model confirmation saying that the events migrated successfully. That was pretty quick. Let's see if it actually works. So if we go back here, we can see that actually some of them were inserted. Let's just refresh again. And there you go. We have 22 records split in 8 pages. So as you can see, the origin, we have 20. Now we have 22 because we had 2 existing before. And we can actually confirm that if we go to the database console, we'll see that the migration data, it actually has 22 records. So there you go. That's how easy is to actually bring your data sources, create queries that inserts or pulls data, and using JavaScript objects, you can migrate the data from one place to another. Now, if you want to modify the data, process the data, do something with the data in the middle before actually inserting into the database, all you have to do is do it in this function here. You can manipulate the parameters. For example, if you need to, let's say, modify the structure or the format of the date, you can use moment.js to modify the date or format the date in the way you want. Because remember, you can bring any JavaScript library into Appsmith, or you can do whatever you need in order to manipulate the data. Now, I'm just passing the data as it is, but in this portion right here is where you will manipulate each of the event data to structure that in a way that the database requires. So there you go. That's how we end this demo episode on the second step about migrating the data. And I hope you understood how easy it is to achieve this goal. So by leveraging Appsmith flexible architecture and integrations, you can easily connect your databases, spreadsheets, and also other types of data sources like REST and GraphQL APIs across environments, and use our existing integrations with AI like OpenAI, Anthropic, and Google Gemini to modernize the migration process. Make sure to check out the videos in the description and also appearing in your screen right now. Lastly, Appsmith can be self-hosted on your existing infrastructure, which means if you need to run the migration app on your own private network, you can easily run Appsmith using Docker, Kubernetes, and many other mechanisms. So make sure to check out our self-hosted playlist here at Appsmith YouTube for more videos. Thank you for joining today and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. See you on the next one.